Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and take myself out of this video so that you guys can see the full image. So, first of all, we had to figure out the enantiomeric excess. The way we figured that out is by saying 70 minus 30% equals what percentage? 40% EE. Okay? So that means that my EE is 40%. So what's my equation? Well, my equation says that my observed rotation should be equal to my specific rotation, which is still positive 20, times my EE, which is now going to be 40%. Okay? Now, we don't really want to work with percentages if we're multiplying, so we would turn this into 0.4, which is just, I'm turning my percentage into a decimal, which is very common. Okay? So now, I would just multiply these together. And what I'm going to get is that 20 times 0.4 is going to equal positive 8. Okay? So my enantiomeric excess here should have been 40%. And my observed rotation, instead of being positive 20, which is what it would be if it was 100, it's going to be positive 8. Now, how does that intuitively make sense? Well, actually, it makes a lot of sense. If you think about it, remember what I said about racemic. Racemic isn't optically active. Well, if I were to look at my tube as broken up into parts, what I would see is that the 70% is actually broken up into two parts. There's 30% here, S, that is perfectly canceled out by 30% R. So what that means is that this entire area right here is racemic, okay? And the racemic portion adds up to, I'm just going to put here racemic. The racemic portion adds up to what? It adds up to 60% because I have 30 and 30. That means that the only part of this that's optically active, let's put that back. That means that the only part of this that's optically active is the extra remaining S, or the enantiomeric excess, and that part equals 40%. Okay? So that means that even though my S would love to rotate this positive 20, there's only 40% of it available that can actually rotate it, because the other 30% is being canceled out by 30% of R. Okay? So what that means is that only 40% is functional, and that's why it's only 40% of the total rotation is that's happening. Out of the total rotation that I could have, only 40% of that is actually taking place, so it's positive 8%.